Exactly. So you have these accounts, and as I researched the Gospels, these ancient biographies of Jesus, I came to the conclusion that they were written very close to the events they report. They're rooted in eyewitness testimony. They've been passed along in a reliable way through the centuries. I mean, they bore the earmarks of accuracy. They're confirmed by archaeology and outside testimony at various points. So I came to conclude that the documents that make up the New Testament are reliable in terms of what they tell me about Jesus.
Yeah, 1 Corinthians 15 is one of those hallmark ones.
Yeah, the first thing I did, I looked at four things. First one was Jesus really dead? And, you know, even the Journal of the American Medical Association carried an investigation into the death of Jesus, and they concluded clearly the weight of the historical and medical evidence indicates that Jesus was dead even before the wound to his side was inflicted.
Right.
So even the atheist scholar Gerd Ludemann says it's indisputable that Jesus was dead. But then secondly, as you point out, we have a report of the resurrection that comes virtually immediately after it took place, not a long time later after legend has developed and contaminated the account. And how do we know that? Well, we know that Saul of Tarsus, a hater of Christians, 1 to 3 years after the death of Jesus, is on the road to Damascus. Boom, he has this encounter with the risen Christ. He becomes the Apostle Paul. Immediately he goes into Damascus and he meets with some apostles. Many people believe this is when he was given this, as you say, this creedal statement of the early church based on eyewitness testimony that says that named people and groups of people, 500 at once as a matter of fact, saw the resurrected Jesus. And many people believe this is when he was given that creed. Some people say it may have been 3 years later when he met with two people named in the creed as eyewitnesses to the resurrection, James and Peter. He met with them for 15 days, and it would be logical they would pass this along. But either way, this means within 1 to 6 years after the death of Jesus, this creedal statement based on eyewitness accounts is already in existence, and therefore the beliefs that make up that creed go back even earlier, virtually to the cross itself.
Yeah,
and so one of the greatest historians in this area, James D.G. Dunn, said, we can be entirely confident this was formulated as a creed within months of Jesus' death.
That's right. One guy from Oxford just came out and said it might have been within weeks.
Yes.
And that means it goes right straight back to the guys that were in Jerusalem that saw all this stuff happening.
You know what I call that in my business, John? That's a news flash.
Yeah.
You know?
It's also eyewitness reports.
Exactly. I mean, that is powerful, powerful. And so many people have come to faith in Jesus Christ based on that 1 Corinthians 15 passage.